In a forest, an eagle used to live with her two small children. One baby was named Chinku and the other baby Tinku.
Mom, when are we going to learn to fly?
Mom, we also wish to fly and see new different places.
You are very young now, children, so you cannot fly. In a few days, you will grow feathers and then you will also spread your wings and fly high in the sky. Saying this, the eagle flew into the sky. And after hours of hard work, she brought some food for her children. Then all the three of them sat and ate together.
Mom, if you were not there in correct time, then we don't know what would have happened.
Oh, my children, it's a difficult job to look for food. You will know when you grow up.
This was the routine of this eagle. Every day she used to work hard to bring food to her children. And then she would feed her children and be very happy. Gradually days passed. Now Chinku and Tinku had grown their feathers.
Mom, can we fly now?
Yes, it appears to be so. Let us try.
As soon as the mother said this, both of them one by one jumped down from the branch and fluttering their wings flew into the sky. Eagle mother was very happy seeing her babies fly and then she called them back and said,
Children, at this age too, I bring food for you both. I feel very tired, but now it's time. Get food for yourself as well as for me. And rest of my days, I will spend in eating and resting.
Yes, Mom, for sure we will search for food.
Saying this, both of them flew into the sky. Eagle mother was very happy seeing her children.
Brother, firstly, let us go to the Black Mountains. I heard a lot about it.
Yeah, let's go.
Both of them flew to the Black Mountains and enjoyed themselves to the fullest. Then they went to the pond. There too, they spent all their time in fun and frolic. Until the evening, they were just moving around here and there and came back to their nest. Eagle mother saw them coming back with empty hands and asked,
Dear children, you had gone out in search of food, but why did you come back with nothing?
Mummy, we worked very hard to look for food, but we could not get anything.
How can this be possible?
Indeed, this is what happened, Ma. We are very tired. It appears we have to sleep on empty stomachs.
Eagle mother was very worried to hear this.
Don't say this, children. While the mother is still alive, children cannot sleep on hungry stomach.
She went out in search of food.
I don't know how much time mother will take. I am feeling so hungry.
She will come back. We have to be patient.
Poor eagle. Working very hard, she brought some food for her children. As soon as she kept the food in front of the children, both of them started gorging on it. Mother eagle was feeling very happy seeing her children eating the food. Both of them slept after eating food. And the next morning, they flew off again. Even today, they went on playing and came back without collecting anything. The eagle mother saw her hungry children and she got very worried. And after working hard for many hours, she brought back food for them again. But even on the third day when this happened, eagle found something suspicious. She felt as if her children were not really feeling her worries. That's why the next day when the children left the nest,
if my children become lazy at this growing age, after some time when I die, how will they live their lives? I'm feeling so worried thinking about this.
After some time when Tinku and Chinku came back to their nests, they did not find their mother in the nest and were very worried.
they found the parrot sitting beside their nest, a bird and a crow also.
Mittu uncle, did you see our mother? Where did she go?
If we can't find her, then who will find food for us? I'm feeling so hungry.
She has now gone to a place from where she cannot come back.
We are unable to understand what you want to say.
Due to some weakness in the afternoon, she died.
What are you telling, Uncle? How this can happen?
With idiotic children like you, it can happen. After growing up also, you were expecting your mother to bring food. Poor thing, she used to fly out in the night to look for food. She used to feed you and be hungry all the time. Because she did this every day, she had started growing very sick and she died in the afternoon. We have just come back after burying her.
Tinku and Chinku felt very unhappy hearing this. They realized the mistake that they had made. Tears welled up in their eyes.
We are so bad. We felt this today. Being a mother, she never allowed us to stay hungry. Even if we are two, but still we can't do anything for her. We are so bad.
Now keep cursing yourself. We are going back to our house. May the God not grant such children to anyone.
Saying this, all the birds flew back. But both the children were now feeling very bad about themselves. They went on crying the whole night. In the morning, when they were feeling hungry again, they flew out of their nest. Today, they were not in the mood of having fun. They were just looking for food.
Brother, we were flying for so many hours, but we couldn't find anything. Whenever we were hungry, Mom could get us the food in minutes.
Both of them started crying once again. By evening, they had brought some food and they flew back towards their nest. When they came back to their nest, they found the absence of their mother.
Brother, you were feeling hungry. Why don't you eat?
You start eating, Tinku. I'm not feeling hungry. I'm feeling so bad. I am remembering our mother.
Yes, brother. Even I don't want to eat this food.
At this moment, their eagle mother came back and she started smiling, looking at her children. They were surprised seeing their mother and both of them ran to her.
Ma, you are alive. Why you left us like this?
Yes, my children, I'm alive. To teach you a lesson, I had to do this. Forgive me.
No, Mom, please forgive us. We did wrong to you. You did all these things to give us a lesson. No, today you will eat first, then we will have it.
Hearing this, the eagle mother started crying. She started eating. You all start eating too. Mother cannot eat, keeping her children hungry. Now Chinku and Tinku also started eating food. Getting their mother back, they were feeling very, very happy. At that point, the parrot, crow, and other birds came in. And they started smiling seeing all the three of them. They were actually friends in the plan that the eagle had made. From that day onwards, Chinku and Tinku became responsible birds. They started loving their eagle mother. Now every day they used to bring back food for themselves as well as their mother. And all the three of them used to enjoy the food together.